Hey guys, welcome back to the This Is Still a Skate Shop YouTube channel. When you pick your favorite setup, there's two big choices that you need to make. What kind of boot you choose and what kind of frame setup you choose. Today I'm gonna explain you everything you need to know about how to choose the best frame setup for your skating style. Inline skates emerge as an off-season ice hockey equipment, and the boots already existed, so the only thing they kind of needed to develop was the frames to start inline skating. And the early frames were all kind of like the same. They all were riveted on the boot like this on the side. They all had four wheels and they all had a wheelbase, meaning the length of the frame that is the same as the foot length. So for all the early skates, the bigger sizes would also have a bigger frame. And this today is still the golden standard. After this generic period, there was an evolution within the inline skating hardware in the 90s, and wheels got smaller, bigger, or more wheels. There are differences between the setups in the amount of wheels a frame has. So for example, this frame has 5 wheels and it's to have a long wheelbase and still be close to the ground. It used to be used by speed skaters, but nowadays a frame setup like this is only used by downhill skaters that go like 100 kilometers an hour down a mountain, so you want to be really stable and really low to the ground. It's however really bad for going slow. You have still like the golden standard. This is 4x80, and then you have different length for this. And there's also 2 wheels. This is for aggressive skating. The frame has a big groove in the middle where you can grind on. This is sliding over a rail. If you want to have fun in the skate park and be an aggressive skater, choose this because it's a lot of fun. Then since a couple of years, there have been a revolution in the inline skating market with 3 big wheels like this, or even this one is 125 millimeters. This adds a lot of height, so it makes you kind of unstable on your skates, but it also gives you the benefit of speed because bigger wheels go faster. If you're not really secure with your braking techniques, I would not choose this. Like if you're doing marathons, then maybe the 3 big wheels are perfect for you. A lot of marathon skaters skate on a long wheelbase with 3 really big wheels like this. You have to think to yourself if that's worth it for you. If you're not sure, then go for 4x80 or like a smaller format, because that gives you a lot more control. Here with this skate, I can put my finger underneath here, so there's about 1 centimeter of extra height. This is due to the mounting system of this skate. Weirdly enough, this is a very new skate, and the old mounting system that was used in the 80s and in the 90s with the rivets on the side here allows you to make a skate that's actually lower. So we kind of like had a step backwards in height utility towards the frame mounting systems. And now, this is also, by the way, an example of a skate that's pretty low because it's mounted on the side. And now here, Power Slide made a new mounting system with the bolts on the side so that you don't have the big bolt here in the middle, which forces you to have the extra height. And with this new mounting system, you can be really, really low. There's different ways to mount a frame to the boot. And the lowest frame mounting system available is the Trinity mount from Powerslide. The other mounting systems are, it's called the 165 millimeter mount. And this is the length between the holes here. It's 165 millimeter distance. This is actually an ice skating mounting standard. And I think it comes from speed ice skating, and that after the speed inline skaters took it over from speed ice skating, that standard kind of like also was implemented in recreational skates and etc. So this is the most universal inline skating standard. It's called 165 millimeter mount. There's also 100 95 millimeter mounting. This is not very common, but it's also a thing. And one other mounting is the universal frame system, and this is for aggressive skating. So if you see a frame like this with really small wheels, it's most likely that it has the universal frame system. The distance between the bolts here to put the frame on the boot is also about 165 millimeter. It's actually 167 millimeter, but the difference is that it's flat here, and with the 165 mount, there's a little levitation height difference here. Okay, with the universal frame system, there's also different wheel sizes possible. So here you see this is also flat, so this is also a universal frame system frame mounting, and this one is also flat with two holes, so it's also the universal frame system. With all those frame mounting standards, there's also ice frames that can be used to put on all the different boot categories with all the different frame mounting. So this is a UFS ice frame, but we also have a Trinity ice frame and a 165 millimeter ice frame. So you can convert all your inline skates to ice skates. So this is my skate right now. And the special thing with my boot is that I can detach this thing here and then take off my complete frame set like this. So when I'm skating, I'm using my big wheels, but then when I'm in the skate park, I usually have this frame set in my backpack, and then I can take it out of my backpack and put it right on my skate like this. Whoop. So I have a very fast changing system. I have one boot and multiple frames. You can of course always do the same thing, but then you have to bolt on your frames and take it off with an Allen key. But for me, it's just super fast. The frames that I use is, I have this one. It's 4x84 millimeter. I have an aggressive frame, and I have this. It's called the Wizard frame. And what makes it special is that it's a really long wheelbase. So the front and back axle are very far apart. Normally, this means that you have really slow stride. So this means that getting speed is not very fast. Like an ice hockey skater can like charge like this, ta 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 ta. But if you have a long wheelbase, your strides are really slow, and it's more suited for high speed, like a marathon skater. But now comes the but. I have a long wheelbase, but I'm still maneuverable. And the way they found a solution for this is to have a rocker. A rocker is when a frame allows the front and the back wheels not to touch. So even though it looks like I have a long wheelbase, actually I'm only skating on two wheels here, or maybe when I put some weight on it, it's three wheels. So that makes me still maneuverable, and I can still have the benefit of the big wheels because I have a rocker. This special frame is mounted with the universal frame system standard, so it's only applicable for aggressive skate boots. If you have a 165 millimeter mounting boot like an FR skate like this, you can put the endless frame on it, and whoop, that fits right on it. And then you also have the same thing, you have a really long wheelbase with big wheels, and you're still maneuverable. So this is my aggressive skate setup, and you can notice also one more difference between my Wizard freestyle skating setup or my Ground Control freestyle skating setup is that this frame is made from plastic. And the main reason why it's from plastic is because plastic is really smooth to grind on. For this, you have a groover in the middle. Now you notice I only have two wheels, but you can also skate aggressive with four wheels, with wheels in the middle. But if you have the wheels in the middle here, then have like a really small groove. And if you have two wheels, you can have like a bigger groove. So I really like grinding, so I wanna make grinding easier. So I wanna have a big groove. And that's why I only use two wheels. The perfect groove, in my opinion, is one that's the kind of like the shape of a rail, so that if you lock on, that you're really stuck on the rail. Not all aggressive frames are plastic though. There's a resurgence of metal frames within aggressive skating. So for example, this fresh Sola equipment frame, this one just came out and there's a new version. There's a trend within aggressive skating now for bigger wheels, ironically, but the middle wheels still need to be small. So the new Sola frame has bigger wheels on the outside and smaller wheels on the inside, so that the inner wheels can be further away from the center groove and that you still have more space to grind on. So if you want to have a really high-tech aggressive inline skate frame right now, you pick one that has bigger wheels here, smaller wheels in the middle, and still allows you to skate flat with the big groove. All right, to summarize, if you don't know any specific thing that you want for your frame, just keep in mind that you want to have a frame that's about the same length as your foot with four wheels, so that you're as low to the ground as possible. If you specifically want to do aggressive inline skating, then pick a plastic frame because it slides a little bit better than metal frame. If you really want to emphasize on grinding, get two wheels. If you still want to have fun rolling around, because two wheels is really hard to roll around with, pick four wheels, but keep in mind that grinding is a lot harder on four wheels. If you're gonna do speed skating, you can get a long wheelbase and big wheels. Keep in mind that braking techniques and control and steering is a lot harder. If you wanna do slalom skating, get a really short wheelbase so that you're really maneuverable. If you wanna do downhill skating, get a long wheelbase, low to the ground so that you're super stable at high speeds. I hope you had some good information here. Let me know what frame setup you use and what frame setup you think is the most fun to play around with. See you next week.
Subscribe.
Like.
Go to bed early.